All right, Charles, let's figure this one out. It turns out, as I said, there's lots of different ways to make this work. But what we're going to do is move that line that we had for conjunction. What we really want to do now is figure out how to move it down so that now these three points are in the green zone. They're going to output 1 because they're the OR. And the only one in the that's left in the 0 zone, in the red zone, is the 0, 0 case. So how are we going to be able to do that?
Well, since we want it to be the case that either X2 or X1 being 1 gets you above the line, then we need a threshold and a set of weights that put either one of them over. You don't have to have both of them. You only need one of them. So let's imagine a case where X1 is 1 and X2 is 0. Then basically, you're right. There's a whole lot of answers. So a weight of 1 for X1 would give you a 1, right?
Yes.
And so if we made the threshold 1, that would work.
What about weight 2?
Well, we do exactly the same thing. So we set weight 2 equal to 1, and that means that in the case where both of them are 0, you get 0 plus 0, which gives you something less than 1. If one of them is 1 and the other is 0, you get 1, which gives you right at the threshold. And if both of them are 1, then you get 2, which is still greater than 1.
Good. All right. That seems like it works. The other way we could do it is we can keep the weights at another way we can do it is keep the weights where they were before. That just moves this line nice and smoothly down. And then, right, so before we had a threshold of 1.5. Now we need a threshold of like 0.5 ought to do it.
Yep.
Or even less, as long as it's greater than 0. So 1/4 should work as well. So good. So lots of different ways to do that. Right. And cool. Can we do not?
What's not of 2 variables?
That's a good question. Let's do not of 1 variable then.
Okay.